FBI agent suspected in Hillary email leaks found dead in apparent murder-suicide. Pope Francis shocks the world, endorses Donald Trump. Cinnamon roll can explodes inside man's butt.
What do all these stories have in common? They're fake news. Fabricated stories spread as hoaxes or in a calculated attempt to disseminate untruths. Sometimes, fake news results in real consequences.
A man armed with an assault rifle.
And with most major fake news during the election being pro-Trump or anti-Hillary, some think it was instrumental to Trump's election. Though we've heard the term a lot lately, fake news is nothing new. While there are examples going back to the invention of the printing press, fake news may be closest to the yellow journalism of the late 1800s. Before clicks, newspapers fought for readers, and some New York outlets turned to dubious and sensationalist stories.
Woman jumps from Brooklyn Bridge, survives mad leap.
New York papers were even accused of goading the U.S. into the 1898 Spanish-American War, with baseless, exaggerated headlines like these.
Main explosion caused by bomb or torpedo. Spanish ships on our coast. Cinnamon roll can explodes inside man's butt.
Characteristics of yellow journalism include misleading headlines, faked interviews, pseudoscience, lavish use of pictures, and scare headlines in huge print. Sound familiar?
ISIS leader calls for American Muslim voters to support Hillary Clinton.
While fake news isn't news, attempts to combat it are. Facebook, Google, and various nonprofits are trying to prevent fake news from spreading by working with independent journalists to verify facts, labeling inaccurate news, and refusing to run money-making ads on fake news sites. Is fake news a real problem? Tell your reps.